been a while since I made a video, but I'm finally back. I think it's been like 2 months since I made a video. I am truly sorry for that. My excuse is I was busy with school and we had exams and everything. So we're done with exams and it's summer break. And I also didn't have any products to review, but you know, I'm finally back. And as you can tell by all the products behind me, I'm going to be doing a PC build. Now this is a budget PC build. All the parts I have at cost around $600. So this is the part one, which is the video where I tell you about all the parts I used. I'll have all the links in the description to all the parts I use. So if you want to purchase them, you can do so. And you should keep in mind that the prices of PC parts are always changing. So yeah, so with all the parts behind me, I am going to be doing a build. And yeah, so I'm just going to give you an overview of the parts. And in the part two of this series, I'm going to be doing a time lapse of the build. And then for the part three, I'm going to be doing some benchmarks and performance tests of the PC. Now this is going to be like an editing / gaming PC, so it's really good price to performance ratio. And like I said, it all costs around $600. So let's, without further ado, let's just get right into the part. So for the processor, I went with the AMD FX6300. Now the reason I went with this processor is because it's a 6-core processor clocked at 3.5 GHz and it also turbo boosts to 3.9 GHz. So it being a 6-core, it's going to be able to handle gaming and everything throughout it. And because it's 6-cores, it can handle all the rendering that I'm going to be doing on the PC. Also, for a price of $120, it has an amazing price of performance ratio and it beats out the Core i3 in benchmarks, and it even goes closer to the Intel Core i5s. So for a price of $120, I really recommend the CPU and you can't go wrong with it. So for the motherboard, I decided to go with the MSI 978-G43. Now first of all, this motherboard does support the AM3 Plus socket, which is the socket that our CPU uses, and it does have a bounty of other features too. So for the most part, it does, not for the most part, it supports quad channel memory, so you can, and it also supports dual channel memory, so you can alleviate the benefits of running in quad channel or dual channel memory. It supports 1866 megahertz memory clock speeds and also 1600 megahertz clock speed. So it also supports super fast memory, so you're covered in that area. It also does have SATA 3, which gives you 6 gigabit per second speeds, so it's going to be really fast. In terms of if you want to put an SSD in this build, you can do so with this motherboard. And last but not least, this motherboard also does support overclocking, so if you're into overclocking, you can easily overclock the CPU. As I said, since it's an unlocked processor, you can like easily overclock it, so it's a good thing that this motherboard supports overclocking. And the price of this motherboard is $69.99 on Newegg. So yeah, it's a really good motherboard for the price, and that's what I went with. For the RAM, I decided to go with 8 GB of Kingston HyperX Black memory. Now this memory is clocked at 1600 MHz, so it's going to be plenty fast for our build. It does have a cache latency of 9, and it comes in 2x4 GB sticks. So we will be running this memory in dual channel, which makes it faster. So for a price of $75.99, it's a really good memory, and it does have some really good reviews too, and it's really high quality as it is from a big name manufacturer like Kingston. Now, the black version is not available right now on Amazon. It's the blue version, and it's pretty much for the same price of $75.99. The only thing that's different is the color of the RAM itself, but performance wise, there's literally no difference. It's just aesthetically. So don't worry if you don't get the exact same RAM as me. It's pretty much the same thing, just that the RAM is blue. For storage, I went with the Western Digital Capture Blue 1 TB drive. Now it's a 7200 RPM drive, so it's going to be fast for a build. And in the future, if you feel like getting an SSD, you can do so and like upgrade. That's the beauty of PC. But for you guys, I'm going to leave the link to the Seagate Barracuda hard drive in the description. Now the reason I'm doing this is because right now the Seagate Barracuda is cheaper than a Western Digital Carrier Blue, and they're essentially the same thing. They're both 1 TB drives, and they both have 7200 RPM speeds. It's just that right now the Seagate Barracuda is the cheaper drive, and because we're on a budget, I would like to keep things, the prices of things in check. So the link in the description is just going to be the Seagate Barracuda. So don't worry, they're essentially the same drives, and there's pretty much no difference. For the optical drive, I just went with a standard ASUS DVD, CD, reader, and writer. So just in case you just want to install the operating system or just watch the occasional DVD or just burn some DVDs, the disk drive will just be fine. It's only $19.99, and you know, I just put it in there. So you can take it out if you want to, but I decided to keep it in there because I will be installing the operating system through this DVD drive. For the graphics card or video card, I went with the Sapphire Radeon R9 270. Now this is a really, really, really good graphics card for the price. It can max out all games at 1080p at ultra settings. It does have 2GB of GDDR5 memory, and it uses a 256-bit memory bus, and it's an AMD graphics card. And yeah, for a price of $164, it's going to be good for editing and also gaming at ultra, like maxing out all the games you're going to be doing on this graphics card. To power up everything in this build, I went with the Corsair CX500 watt power supply. It's an 80 plus bronze certified power supply, so it has really good efficiency. And I got this for $53, but for you guys, I'm going to be giving you the link to the EVGA 500 watt power supply. It's a really good power supply. It's also 80 plus certified, and it has a 5-star rating on Amazon. So that's a really good rating, and I like, that's a really good power supply, and it's 500 watts, so it's going to be enough to power everything in this build, and even maybe hold enough power to give you some future upgrades. For example, adding in some extra hard drives, some extra SSDs, and some extra fans. So it's a really good power supply. Both of these power supplies are really good for the price. So the EVGA power supply costs $39.99. Now for the case, which is going to hold all our parts together, I went with the NZXT Source 220 windowed edition. Now, the NZXT Source 220 is like the big brother to the NZXT Source 210. First of all, it has really good airflow. It has a mesh front, so air can go in easily. And yeah, it's a steel / plastic case. It has a really minimalistic design, and I really think it looks really good, in my opinion. I'm a big fan of minimalistic cases, so I really like the look of it. It's a mid-tower case, so it will support our motherboard, and all the parts that we're using are going to fit inside this case. Now the specific version I went with is only available at Newegg, and at Newegg they sell both the NZXT Source 220 and the NZXT Source 220 windowed edition. Now the windowed edition from Newegg comes with 3 LED fans, it's also the same price as the normal NZXT Source 220, $50. So I was like, why not get the one with 3 LED fans? And it does look pretty sick, in my opinion. 2 LED fans in the front and one in the back for exhaust. So this case is also, like I said, it has a window so you can see the internals and everything of what you did. And it's a really, really good case for the price of $50. It has really good airflow. For my build, I decided to get something extra. I got an ASUS Wi-Fi adapter because I'm planning to use my PC on Wi-Fi just a little bit. But for you guys, you can also add this. It's an optional item, so I'll still leave the links in the description. But please know that if you do end up purchasing this ASUS Wi-Fi adapter, it's going to bring the total cost of the build to $630. It's still in the $600 price range, but it's just something I wanted to let you guys know. So guys, there you have it. It's a $600 build. All of these parts end up with a cost up to a total of $595.93. So it's $5 under $600. So I don't know, you could save that $5 to get a pizza or something. But yeah, this is let's start. So the CPU was $119.95. The motherboard was $69.99. The RAM was $75.99. The hard drive was 50 4.99. The PSU was 39.99. It's actually on sale right now. The case was 49.99. The off-the-go drive was 19.99. And the GPU was 164.99. Well, pretty much everything ends up in 99, but whatever. So it's all under $600. And yeah, so you guys, be sure to tell me what you think about this build in the comments below. This is my first PC build. And tell me if you guys like want me to be doing PC builds from now on. And I'm also thinking of starting a new series where at the end of each month, I'm going to do a video talking about the best deals in PC and mobile technology. So if you want me to start a series like that, let me know in the comments below. That's pretty much it. This was my first PC build. I'm sorry that the video was so long. I didn't notice until now, so I'm really sorry about that. And I'll try and make my videos more compact in the future. But be sure to tell me what you guys think about this PC build in the comments below. It was my first build, like I said already. And yeah, so watch out for part 2 and part 3 of the gaming PC or / editing PC build guide. Be sure to tell me what you guys think about this video and this PC build in the comments below. If you like it, the video, leave a like. If you dislike it, dislike it. And you can feel free to ask me any questions in the comments down below. And subscribe if you're not. Anyway, guys, this has been Kelvin, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace.